Yes, that glorious music means that it's sermon time, Tice's Sunday sermon, when I give my views to listeners, viewers, my supporters, the flock, because this is, of course, the time for people to release their anxieties. If you have concerns, frustrations, then if you ring us through the show, I'll help you at least release those frustrations, even if I can't cure them. And this week, for my Sunday sermon, I'm going to be focusing on the remarkable, the mysterious outcomes and results of democracy and the elections this week. We'll be talking later in the show about what's been the results in Northern Ireland, seismic change potentially coming there. But for the sermon, I want to talk about something closer to these studios. Yes, the results in Tower Hamlets this week, because against all expectations, the good voters of Tower Hamlets have elected Lufthur Rahman as their mayor again, despite the fact that he was previously elected in 2014 and then removed from office in 2015 because he was found by the judge of the electoral court to have personally been guilty of corrupt and illegal practices. So he was removed from office. The judge described him as ruthless and dishonest, and he was banned for 5 years until last year, coincidentally, funnily enough, 2021, from standing for any elected office. And he was ordered to pay costs of £250,000. The judge said that Mr. Rahman drove a coach and horses through electoral laws and did not care. He was accused of personation of postal votes and at ballot stations. And this is why voter ID at elections is so essential, and why I'm delighted that it has now been passed in the Elections Act of 2022. It's already used in Northern Ireland and dramatically reduced the risks of personation. Now, I should say, Mr. Rahman, of course, denied all the allegations. He was not convicted in a criminal court. But it does seem to me remarkable that anybody essentially found guilty by the electoral court of those illegal practices should be allowed to stand again. Now, Mr. Rahman is leader of a political party you may not have heard of, called Aspire. Wonderful motivational name that was launched in 2018. And in April 18, they raised cash donations of £2,225 and non-cash items of just over £7,500. Now, having launched in January 18, of the 45 councillors in Tower Hamlets, 10 of them defected from Labour to this new party, Aspire. But it didn't seem to work out very well for those 10, because in the May 18 elections, all 10 of those councillors lost their seats. Aspire stood in all 45 wards and secured precisely zero councillors. That was 4 years ago. And of course, things changed, yes. Because in 2019, Aspire, they did actually win a council ward by-election. So they must have been doing something. And yet, in that same year, 2019, in their annual return to the Electoral Commission, this new political party, Aspire, they said they had no income, no expenditure, and no local activity in Tower Hamlets. So my question is, how could you fight and win a by-election if you had no local activity in Tower Hamlets? And then again in 2020, exactly the same annual return to the Electoral Commission stating that they had no income, no expenditure, and no local activity in Tower Hamlets. Now, we've not yet seen the 2021 return to the Electoral Commission. What we do know is that in their quarterly returns to the Electoral Commission, they have shown continually, right up until the present day, zero income. Zero income. Now, let me tell you, I run a political party. I know how hard it is to make people aware of your existence. It takes money, effort, activity, social media, hard work, campaigning. It really does. It's not easy. And then in 2021, Aspire, they won another by-election, a ward by-election in Tower Hamlets. So coming into this elections, they had two councillors out of 45. And yet, in these elections, here we are, Mr. Rahman won the mayoralty. extraordinary. And they've gone for the Aspire party. They stood candidates in all 45 wards, and they went from 2 councillors to 24. They've taken control of the council with its budget of hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of millions of pounds, and a housing budget approaching, I think, almost 100 million pounds. They've taken the control of this council despite seeming to have no income and no campaigning activity. Well, how have they done this? I mean, this feels unique. It's extraordinary. It's remarkable. Absolutely remarkable. How have they won the mayoralty and control of the council despite no money coming in, no campaigning activity in 2019 or 2020, and seemingly no donations to fund any activity in 2021? And what's also remarkable is the good voters of Tower Hamlets are clearly very engaged in democracy, because they have the highest turnout of any mayoral election across the whole of England in the last 3 years, except Sadiq Khan's London mayoral elections. Remarkable. How have they done this? Is it through social media? Well, let's have a look at their Twitter account, shall we? And here the mystery grows, folks. Because their Twitter account, set up in 2018, has the astounding, massive total of 339 followers. Yes, 339 followers. And have they been busy with their Twitter account? Well, they have sent the extraordinary total, in 4 years, of just 88 tweets. 88 tweets. I couldn't find a Facebook page at all. So let's be honest, they ain't big on social media, folks. But maybe they've got an amazing website that sets out all their policies so that we all understand and their voters are impressed by it. Guess what? It's the first time I can recall in many, many years, they have no website. No website. There's just one page that says, we're building a website. Really? A political party that's won control of a council, won the mayoralty, has no website, no social media presence. What's gone on here? I'm confused, folks. Help me, please. I simply don't understand how you can convince voters to vote for you if you've got no policies, no website, no social media presence, no evidence of any expenditure or donations or campaigning, except there were a few pictures of some leaflets and rosettes over the last few weeks. This, to me, is a mystery. And it raises more questions than answers that I think over the coming days need to be asked by the media and voters in Tower Hamlets. We must ask the Electoral Commission to ask these questions. Who paid for these brochures and these nicer rosettes? Have the councillors paid them all themselves? Have the councillors paid into central party funds to help fund the mayoral campaign? How much money has the new mayor, Mr. Rahman, spent on his campaign? Where's the money come from? When will it be declared? Perhaps their spending returns will reveal all. Now, I went to the count last night as the count was finishing, and actually I was lucky enough briefly to meet Mr. Rahman. I asked him to come on the show today to answer these questions to the great viewers and listeners of Talk TV. He said he was tempted, and his team, I was put in touch with them. I asked them and I phoned them again this morning, but they declined to come on the show. They're very welcome, of course, to come on the show next week to answer these questions. I think it's important because I'm confused. I need help. How could they achieve these results with no social media, no money, no campaigning activity? It all feels a bit of a mystery to me. Here endeth my Sunday sermon.